What has been? You communicate with Mars, converse with spirits, report the behavior of the sea monster, describe the horoscope, horoscope or scribe, observe disease in signatures, evoke biography from the wrinkles of the palm, and tragedy from finger. Fiddle with pentagrams, or barbituric acids, or dice. Explore the womb, or tomb, or dreams. All these are usual pastimes. There will be some of them, especially when there is distress of nations and perplexity. Curiosities searches past and future and clings to that which of the times with time is an occupation for the saint. No occupation I know but so. In selflessness and self-surrender, for most of us there is.
Thank you.
uncertain hour before the morning, near the ending of interminable night, at the recurrent end of the unending, after the dark dove with the flickering tongue had passed below the horizon of his homing, while the dead leaves still rattled on like tin, over the asphalt where no other sound was, between three districts whence the smoke arose, I met one walking, loitering and hurried, as if blown towards me like the metal leaves before the urban dawn wind unresisting. And as I fixed upon the downturned face, that pointed scrutiny with which we challenge the first met stranger in the waning dusk, I caught the sudden look of some dead master, whom I had known, forgotten, half recalled, both one and many, in the brown baked features, the eyes of a familiar compound ghost, both intimate and unidentifiable. So I assumed a double part and cried, and heard another's voice cry, "What, are you here?" Although we were not, I was still the same, knowing myself, yet being someone other. And he, a face still forming, yet the words sufficed to compel the recognition they preceded. And so, complying to the common wind, too strange to each other for misunderstanding, in concord at this intersection time of meeting nowhere, no before and after, we trod the pavement in a dead patrol. I said, "The wonder that I feel is easy, yet ease is cause of wonder, therefore speak. I may not comprehend, may not remember,
and he, I am not eager to rehearse my thought and theory which you have forgotten. These things have served their purpose, let them be. So with your own, and pray they be forgiven by others as I pray you to forgive both bad and good. Last season's fruit is eaten, and the full-fed beast shall kick the empty pail, for last year's words belong to last year's language, and next year's words await another voice. But as the passage now presents no hindrance to the spirit unappeased and peregrine between two worlds become much like each other, so I find words I never thought to speak in streets I never thought I should revisit, when I left my body on a distant shore. Since our concern was speech, and speech impelled us to purify the dialect of the tribe and urge the mind to aphrasite and foresight, let me disclose the gifts reserved for age, to set a crown upon your lifetime's effort. First, the cold friction of expiring scents, without enchantment, offering no promise but bitter tastelessness of shallow fruit, as body and soul begin to fall asunder. Second, the conscious impotence of human rage at folly, and the laceration of laughter at what ceases to amuse. And last, the rending pain of reenactment of all that you have been and done, the shame of motives late revealed, and the awareness of things ill done and done to others' harm, which once you took for exercise of virtue. Then fool's approval stings, and honor stains. From wrong to wrong, the exasperated spirit proceeds, unless restored by that refining fire, where you must move in measure like a dancer." The day was breaking. In the disfigured street, he left me with a kind of valediction and faded on the blowing of the horn.
Indeed. will the self, which, as it could, love them, to become renewed, transfigured in our better, sins be hallowed, but all shall be well, and all men think shall be good.
History is now ending, but